points, couple rebounds, knocked the ball away from Landale. A little bit of everything out of Joseph Samoyer.
Portland product.
Shaver going to work on Hermanson, knocks it down in the paint.
And that's something else that those two guys can do, Shaver and Walker. With their speed and quickness, their ball handling ability, they can break defenses down off the dribble.
There's points tonight for the leading scorer on this Portland squad. Nahr looking at a double team. Neal puts a head down, creates some room, and inside the flush by Hunter.
All right.
Hunter, the crowd.
Hunter that time being aggressive. Kind of giving you a little Steven Adams, even though Steven Adams is a Kiwi. That one's off.
Rarely will you see DeMarcus Tyson miss that badly, but he'll keep shooting. Neal fouled by Diabate. He made his move baseline. Second personal on Diabate, 10th team foul, so double bonus for Cullen and Neal. Senior out of Albuquerque, a transfer from Ole Miss, shoots just over 80% at the line. Capable of having a impact offensively on a game, had a season high of 18 against Gonzaga this season. Averages 6 per contest. Lane violation on Hunter, so that takes a point off the board.
You know, Cullen Neal actually played for his dad at New Mexico, then went to Ole Miss, and now the graduate transfer at St. Mary's.
Malcolm Porter. Samoyer's return. Shaver drives. I think he was losing control of the ball as he went up, but I think Hermanson got him on the foul.
Yeah, and you can see it. Part of the game plan is for those guards to attack off the dribble because they know they have a speed and quickness advantage.
Second personal on Hermanson. 7th team foul, so the bonus the rest of the way for Portland. Shaver at the line to shoot 2. We understand we have lost our video due to a power hit we've taken here in the Portland area, so we apologize for your loss of picture. We understand, again, you do hear us. We will try to get that video reestablished as soon as possible. 4:10 remaining in the first half. Portland Pilots with a 27-26 lead. Tanner Krebs goes down low to Chuck Landell, who's returned. Missed 3 by Neal, but the offensive rebound. Hermanson corner, 3 ball, no good. And Malcolm Porter with the rebound, pushing to front court.
Yeah, our pregame meeting with the Portland staff, they told us that they were going to give Landale different looks. That time you saw that double team come, and it was a good aggressive double team.
Jackson pull up from 15, no good. Rebound Neal. Neal into front court, right side. Goes baseline, reverse lay, and good. Well done by Cullen Neal.
Yeah, he can score. I had a chance to see him play some when he was at New Mexico. I mean, he can score the basketball.
And St. Mary's back in front, 28-27, 3:10 remaining in the half. Jackson guarded by Neal. Tyson open at the foul line, no good. Neal with the board and the push. And a foul away from the ball. Samoyer in a little too physical with Landale. And And a timeout here at the Childs Center. 2:57 remaining in the first half. St. Mary's up one, 28-27. Welcome back to the Childs Center. Again, our apologies. A power hit has cost us our video feed for the time being. We are working to get that reestablished as soon as possible. 2:57 remaining in the first half with visiting St. Mary's up 28-27 on the Portland Pilots, who have really done a lot of damage taking advantage of St. Mary's turnovers. 10-2 points off of turnovers in favor of the Pilots so far in this game. Jock Handel at the free throw line for the Gales.
Well, Portland has played some aggressive, you know, scrappy defense. They've changed the looks up that they've given Landell. And, you know, some good outside shooting from Tyson. And they've gotten good minutes on the post from Diabate and Spoyer and Hartwich. So right now the game plan for Portland is working. They're staying close. They survived a 4-minute stint there where they didn't score. So things are looking good for Portland right now.
Jock Landell up to 8 points. Good defense by Hermanson, denying Shaver on the drive. Left side beyond the arc. Rashad Jackson for three. Short. Rebound Landell.
And again, that's the shot that Jackson just took. He's not really a strong outside shooter. There was still 15 seconds left on the clock. That's too early.
15 seconds on the shot clock for the Gales. Emmett Nahr with the ball, top of the key, goes left side. Krebs trying to go low block to Landell. Lost the ball.
Another turnover.
Marcus Shaver Jr. fouled. He will head to the line. Third foul on Calvin Hermanson. So we may see him head to the bench in short order with 2:11 remaining in the first half. Two shots coming up for Marcus Shaver.
And that turnover was created by the defense that Portland is playing. They're being really aggressive. They have active hands. They're really communicating. I think St. Mary's is a little out of sync, I believe, offensively. I mean, we've seen them just be so efficient. And I just think they're a little out of sync offensively, but you have to give the Portland defense credit.
First free throw by Shaver, good. Hermanson to the St. Mary's bench. Jordan Ford returned. Shaver's second free throw, good. And it's a 30-29 St. Mary's lead. 2:05 remaining in the first half. Ford, top of the key with the ball. Little hesitation, dribble through the legs, goes over to Krebs. Skip pass over to Neal in the far corner. Cullen in some trouble. Shot clock at 10. Loose ball inside. Jock Landell cleans up the mess as he lays it in. He's into double figures now with 10 points.
Good hands by Landell. That ball was tipped, but he did a good job of corralling it and laying it in.
Gales up 32-29, 1:30 remaining in the half. And Mary's looking to end a two-game skid. Portland hoping to end a three-game losing streak. Diabate works the baseline in a double-team situation. Goes up strong. Landell with a rebound. Into front court. Ford sees a lane. Cut off. Dribbles back out. Now back into the paint. And as he drove in, he was fouled. That'll go against Rashad Jackson. Free throws coming up for Jordan Ford. 6'1 sophomore out of Folsom, California. Averages just over 9 points per game.
20 the last time they played. Was the leading scorer in that game.
Matched a career high. He's had 3 times this season of 20 points. First free throw is good. Landell with 2 fouls going to the bench, so they'll protect him for the second half. Evan Fitzner, 6'10 junior out of San Diego, replaces Jock. Ford hitting both free throws, now has 4 points.
Tyson's been quiet for a while here. It'd be good to see if Portland could get him something.
Diabate out of a double team. Top of the key. Shaver guarded by Neal. Shot clock at 7. Shaver pull up 2. Drains it. Marcus Shaver Jr.
And that's just good individual offense there. That's just one-on-one, you and me. And that time, Shaver came out on top against Neal.
He has 8 points. Pilots within 3 with 30.2 seconds remaining in the first half as Randy Bennett, head coach of St. Mary's, calls a timeout. 8-second differential between game clock and shot clock. Again, our apologies for the lack of video currently coming from Portland, taking a power hit here, and we are furiously troubleshooting to try to get that picture back to you as soon as we can. Good crowd here tonight, near capacity or at capacity of just over 4,800. Parents' weekend, so some moms and dads in the house.
Parents' weekend, President's Day weekend, Gale's in town.
Brew Fest underway here on campus.
Man, I'm waiting for mine.
Well, they didn't tell us.
As soon as we get off the air, but he is on. They
didn't give us enough advance warning. So
that's okay. We'll play catch up.
That's right. We'll follow the crowd after the game and see, see where they go. Gale's inbound to Emmett Nahr. Left-handed dribble.
I wondered if they wanted to call that timeout to get Landale back in the game for offense to defense, and they did. And, we might have an ankle with Nahr down there.
He converted the lay-in and then hit the deck and is still down. And now a timeout call with 8.6 seconds remaining in the half. I think you're right. It looked like it was the left ankle that he reached. And oftentimes when you see that injury, it's a player coming down on another player's foot. But we'll...
He just, you know, he tried to get up and he couldn't. And, man, you just hope it's not anything serious.
This guy is the guy who makes everybody on this St. Mary's squad better, the way he distributes the basketball. So we see him go up. It may have been hard to tell on the video that we are seeing in the building. We're now looking at another angle. This was out of a pick and roll. Can't quite tell if he just came down awkwardly or if he came down on another player's foot. He is being taken to the locker room and very questionable based on the way he hobbled off whether we will see Emmett Nahr in the second half of this game. Let's hope we do.
Yep, well, Ford and Neal, they'll have to pick up the slack.
6 seconds remaining in the half. Ford on the drive all the way to the rack. Couldn't get the finish. Rebounded by the Pilots as time expires in the first half. A very good, entertaining first half. One that was 5 points better, though, for St. Mary's. The Gales with the lead at the break.